Hello and welcome to our final video of Mobile World Congress highlights. Now coming way out of left field, it's Puma who have teamed up with Sage & Wireless to bring us the Puma phone, promising to be unlike any other handset. And with a solar panel at the back for wireless charging, it certainly isn't. Not aimed at business users, the Puma packs a range of lifestyle features, including the scratching turntable app for your MP3s, easy photo sharing, and a sarcastic calculator that apparently has fun with you while giving you the answers. And you can also pull up Dylan the Puma on your home screen whenever you want. Now, if that's not enough to make you want it, I don't know what is. Now, its other features are pretty bog standard, and there's no Wi-Fi. Tut tut, Puma. It's another Android 2.1 powered handset, and this time from Acer, dubbed the Liquid E, a follow-up to the Liquid A1. Like the majority of handsets unleashed at Mobile World Congress this year, it packs a 1GHz Snapdragon processor and a 3.5-inch capacitive touchscreen, complete with multi-touch support, thanks to that operating system upgrade. Moving away from hardware for a minute, and Nokia and Intel have joined forces to create a brand new platform dubbed Migo. It's a combination of Nokia's MIMO operating system and the Linux-based Moblin OS from Intel. Now, the name's not particularly inspiring, and there's no hardware to get excited about, but it has the potential to be a pretty big deal, considering it's aimed at homes, netbooks, tablets, and in-car infotainment systems. Watch this space. Next up, it's Garmin Asus and the Nuvifone A50. Now, it's actually the company's first Android handset, so expect it to come with all the usual Google suspects, such as voice search and Google Maps. It will also provide Microsoft Exchange support for contacts, calendar, and email. Now, being a Garmin phone, expect it to come with the navigation software. That means maps, voice-guided navigation, and a range of advanced tools like Lane Assist with Junction View. Sounds pretty handy to me. Now, we haven't seen any particularly rugged handsets, that is until Sonim's XP2 Spirit, the company's first 3G handset, complete with a 2-inch screen protected by 1.5mm of the brilliantly named Gorilla Glass. Sonim tells us it will withstand 2-metre drops, up to 1 hour in 1 metre of water, and temperatures as low as minus 20 degrees. You can also press each button 850,000 times, although your fingers will probably give in before the buttons do. Well, that's it from us and Mobile World Congress, but for the lowdown on all the handsets seen at MWC this year, make sure you check out stuff.tv.